बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम आई एम सैयद इरफान उल्ला एडवोकेट कॉर्पोरेट लॉ पेशावर हाई कोर्ट एंड अ विजिटिंग लेक्चर एट अब्बासियन यूनिवर्सिटी परमानेंट लेक्चर एट अब्बासियन यूनिवर्सिटी पेशावर एंड अ विजिटिंग लेक्चर एट फ्रंटियर लॉ कॉलेज पेशावर वी वर डिस्कसिंग द टाइप्स ऑफ कंपनी सो टुडे I am concluding the type of companies. We have discussed the types of companies on the basis of the liability, and in the previous lectures we have discussed on the basis of the incorporation. Then we discuss on the basis of the liability. So in the liability, the limited companies, the unlimited companies, and limited by the guarantee. In today's lecture we are discussing the other types of the companies on the basis of the number of members, that how much the members can be and how can we divide a company on the basis of the number of members. So a private company which has a minimum paid up capital of 1 lakh or such a higher paid up capital as may be prescribed by its articles, restrict the right of transfer of its shares, limits the number of its members to 50, means the numbers of the members cannot exceed 50. That is the maximum number of members of this company could be maximum 15. Prohibits any invitation to the public to subscribe for any share in debenture of the company. So the public cannot be described and they cannot be invited to purchase the shares in the company in the stock exchange. Prohibits any invitation or acceptance of deposit from the persons other than its members, directors, are their relative, and any member outside these members, that is the maximum 15, the 51st first person cannot be invited from outside other than the relatives of the members or the directors of the company, but they can, but not outside them. A public company means a company which has a minimum paid of 5 lakh or such a higher paid up capital as may be prescribed. Is a private company which is subsidiary of a company which is not a private. Every public company existing on the commencement of the Companies Act 2013 with the paid up capital of 5 lakh within the period of 2 years from such a commencement enhance its paid up capital to 5 lakh. So if we compare it with the previous one, the maximum paid of 1 lakh, here it is 5 lakh. The number of members you can invite from the public also. For example, if you look over here, that you cannot invite from outside, but here you can invite the shareholders from outside, the members of the company, and their assets can be sold in a stock exchange. So this is on the basis of the private company and the public company. So in this type of company we can invite the public to purchase the shares and the capitals, and for the purpose of the debentures. So in the private company this type we cannot invite, but in this type the public company we can invite them on the basis of the control, that how a company could be controlled. So there one type of it is the holding companies. So a company is known as a holding company of another company if it has control over the other company. according to section 404 of the Companies is deemed to be the holding company of another if but only if other is a subsidiary. For example, one company is holding another company. A company creates another company. A company may become a holding company of another company in either of the following three ways: by holding more than 50% of the nominal normal values of issued equity capital of the company. For example, if there are two companies, so the holding company will be that one if it occupies the 50% in the other company of the issuer or the capital value, or by holding more than 50% of its voting rights, or the voting right. For example, if we are going for selection of the directors or other assets, so he has the 50% of the voting rights. That is, there are 50% of the votes belonging to that company. So that will be a holding company, that one company controls another company. Or by securing itself the right of appoint the majority of the directors of the other company directly or indirectly, and it controls the directors, the board of directors, it appoints the directors directly or indirectly. So if you look at here, the holding company is that one which rules on the other companies to have more than a 50% of the capital, the voting right, that is, for the purpose of the decision making, and the directors who are running the routine works of a company. So if you look at it, controls in all respect a holding another company. Subsidiary company is known as the subsidiary company of another company when its control is exercised by the latter. Means the holding company, it is a subsidiary company. So the subsidiary is the smaller one, the holding is the upper hand. So the upper hand or the upper company or the owner company is the holding company, and it rules on the subsidiary company, or it controls the subsidiary company. So a company is known as a subsidiary of another company when its control is exercised by the latter, called the holding company over the. Holding company is controlling the subsidiary company. The holding company is controlling the subsidiary company. So mean the owner and being a owner and a subordinate. So the owner is the holding company, and the subsidiary is the subordinate company. So the holding company is controlling the subsidiary company. On the basis of the ownership, a government company. A government company means a company which in which not less than 51% of the paid up share capital is held by the central government. So which one is the government company in which the government has more than a 50% of the share, or any state or government, or partially the central government, or a party of one or more state government. A subsidiary company of company is also called a government company. So if you look at the PTCL, so PTCL is now the public company, but it was controlled by the government and ruled by the government. So still they have, as you know, a TIP, that is Telephone Industries of Pakistan, is a full government company which is made under the Act of the Parliament and is having more than 50% of the share capital. And if there is maybe a bank also, maybe another trade organizations also, in which the government has more than a 50% capital, is called the government company. Or one man company or sole proprietorship company. So a member may hold virtually the entire share capital of the company. Such a company is known as one man company. So this can happen both in a private company or in a public company. The other member or members of the company may be holding just one share each. Such other members may be just dummies for the purpose of fulfilling the requirements of law as regards of the minimum membership. So a one man company is ruled and governed by a single man, but normally we see that a company is made by two or more people, more than two person to create a company. So rest are just fulfilling of it, because if we limit it, then it will be termed under the Partnership Act. So just to make it according to the law, we are increasing the number of members, but in fact it is a one man company who is ruled and governed by a single person. Our deemed public company Amendment 2013 has introduced a subsection 11 to the section 43. Made in the private company will not automatically become a public company on account of the shareholding of the turnover. Non-trading company or non-profit company or association. Such a company must have the object of promoting of commerce, art, science, religion, charity, or any other useful object, and must, like the NGOs, very simply, applies to its forfeit, if any, or other income in promoting its object, and must prohibit payment of the dividend to its member. So it is only for promotion purposes, or the commerce, art, industry, or the religion, or the charity, made for different purposes. So it doesn't have the profit or the target, or the objective is the target, but just the objective is the commerce, promoting the commerce, arts, science, culture, tourism, and so forth. Investment company. An investment company is a company that is has the principal business of which consists of acquiring, holding, and dealing in shares of the securities. It involves only the acquisition and holding the shares and securities, and thereby earning income by the way of interest and dividend. So investment companies are those who are working as a securities, who are giving the other companies some money to let them do the business, and in return they are getting the interest or the dividend. Means that they are providing the loans in one kind, and on the loans they are getting the interest from those companies. So they are not actually involved in the businesses, but they are promoting the businesses by giving them the loans, and in the return they are caring, or they are interested in the interest, or what you say, the riba or the sood that will be taken in return. Thank you for today, and I am Saeed Irfanullah, the corporate law lawyer at Peshawar High Court, and a visiting lecturer at Frontier Law College, Peshawar. Thank you.